ladies and gentlemen. This is the Olympics of Robotics. 31 nations represented here this week. Over 1,000 teams.
You know, when people talk about skills and they talk about the skills that are needed for the future, they're almost always wrong. Because we never know what kind of jobs are going to be emerging and are going to be created with these new combinations of man-machine working together. We do know that you have to know math and some STEM skills.
I'm Dennis. You are?
Julian.
Julian. So Julian, Alex, Parker and Evan. Okay, here's the bottom line. We're Toyota. We work hard to make the best cars in the world. We don't want second best or third best. The best cars in the world are made by the most talented people in the world, and that's why we look for people like you. Here's my question. Is everybody building the same robot, or are the designs completely what your team comes up with?
Yeah, no. Completely what you come up with.
So this is your unique robot and your unique design?
Yep.
Got it. So you guys gonna take me around and show me what you have here?
Yeah, we're actually doing a practice match right now.
Okay.
Red Alliance, are you guys ready? Blue Alliance, you guys ready? This is match number 19 in 3, 2, 1, go! Here we go, nothing but net. Taking 90 into hard here, 54-54F.
Got
a dead robot on field one, so work those bugs out so we have a smooth running tournament the rest of the weekend, okay?
This battery here that goes powers the brain is loose, so it's coming unplugged,
it's disconnected.
And we're not able to, you know, we're not able to drive at all because it doesn't have power. So we're gonna have to do some work with that and see if we can get that fixed.
Well, they really think about stuff, troubleshooting, engineering, mechanical advantages.
When you've been working on this and putting all your time, do you do it during school or do you do it after school? You do it after school.
We're able to utilize our school's facilities. We're there for, I'd say, an average of 2 hours, pretty much every Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday since August. In almost every competition, we'll have it. We'll all go over to somebody's house the night before that Friday night, and we'll just work on it all night long until that next day.
I've always had a philosophy is don't come to me with a problem unless you have a couple solutions. And now they think that way.
We got a bunch of time.
No matter what they do, engineering, medicine, problem solving is the key. So it doesn't matter what field they go into, problem solving will be with them the rest of their lives.
Beginning of this year, well, I'm going to be blunt, we sucked. And we lost miserably like 2 or 3 competitions in a row. And then we just, you know, you learn from that and you learn how to problem solve around that. And, you know, test and retest and redesign. And it got us here, so.
You guys are making choices on what you do.
Yeah.
And when you make the choice to do this, that tells me a lot about commitment. It tells me a lot about interest. It tells me a lot about work ethic. And you're making some decisions and judgments that other students aren't doing, and that gets our attention, right?
He definitely wants to go into engineering. Of course, I'd love to see him go to Toyota just because he would stay close by, but. You know, he keeps talking about aeronautical engineering and different fields, so. But that's, when he was a little kid, he was always working with Legos and putting them together, and he actually followed the instructions and knew what to do at an early age, so that just stayed with him.
Yeah, there's something in my bag.
The ports in the brain that hold these leads had been just overused and they were stretched out, so this wasn't making contact. So we kind of pried open these leads to where they're wider, so they fit in there better.
Yeah, we're good.
go to our mat. Left. 3, 2, 1. 33's in the books. Here come the results at 32 up on the bid board. 185 to 158. Red over blue. Very, very well done. Back
yeah, we won a match.
I want to go into aerospace engineering, so I plan to go to UK and double major in computer engineering and mechanical engineering, and then get my aerospace certification, and then go from there. I just got accepted to the Governor's Scholar Program here in Kentucky, so that's my full scholarship for UK. With those kind of opportunities, you really can accomplish whatever you want to.